Hello everyone and welcome back to another tutorial. This is the part 4 of the tutorial series where we are creating a humanoid cat character. In this tutorial, we will go through how to add tail to this humanoid cat character that we have created before. We will go in depth in adding the skin weights easily, and we will also go through the settings of spring bones to have a smooth movement for the tail of the character. This was suggested by two of the viewers from the previous video. Thank you for the suggestion. And these are the final results of this tutorial. And let's get right into it. So let's open the character that we have created from the previous tutorial. And let's reset the expressions to 0 and also give a T-pose for calibration. This is the same method that we'll be following from the previous video, but I found two plugins that we can use for Blender and Character Creator to make this process much more easier. This plugin will help us apply the characterization and the textures automatically when we export the character from Blender. So the first one that we'll be downloading is the CC Blender Tools. You can go to code and click on download zip. And the second plugin that we'll be needing is CC4 Blender Pipeline Tool. You can click on code and download zip for this one as well. I'll leave the links to both of these plugins in the description below. First, we'll copy the CC4 Blender plugin for Character Creator. So go to the installation folder of CC4 and go to bin64 folder. Make a new folder called Open Plugin, and you can extract the plugin into this folder. And now you can restart the CC4 application. And now when you go to the plugins menu over here, you can see that there is a new set of tools called Blender Pipeline. Before we can export the character from Character Creator, we need to add the tail as an attachment on this character. So I've already downloaded this model from Sketchfab. Thank you, Jerry4461, for the simple tail model. Let's import this tail into Character Creator and rescale it based on the size of the character. And let's attach this to the character on the hip joint. We will be adding the texture to the tail in the end, so this is good enough for now. We'll export this character using the Blender Pipeline plugin. In the settings, we only need the mesh. So select the first option and make sure these two options are turned on. So it will have the characterization and expression profile included in the export. And we can also use the current pose option. So we'll have the T-pose when we export it. And let's also save the spring options of the ears that we have done in the previous video. So we don't have to work on this again, and we can simply apply these settings after we import it back into CC4. And now we'll open Blender. And the first thing we'll do is install the plugin that we have downloaded before. Go to Edit, Preferences, and in the Add-ons menu, you'll have the option to install. Click on Install and select the zip file that you have downloaded. And you can turn on the plugin over here. And to access the plugin, you need to go to the viewport and click on N on your keyboard. And you will have these two options over here. You can go to CC Pipeline and click on Import Character and select the file we have exported from Character Creator. And now we'll go to the orthographic side view of this character. And you can select any of the bone of the character and go to Viewport Display and select In Front. So we can see the bone structure of the character. and over here you can search for hip joint. Select the hip joint and go to edit mode. And now simply click on E on the keyboard. That will extrude the bone from the hip bone. You can place that here. And you can add few more child bones to complete the bone structure of the tail. And now that we are done with this, we can click A to select all and click on export to CC from the plugin over here. And now we'll go back to Character Creator, create a new project and go to plugins, Blender pipeline and import the character that we exported from Blender. You can leave all the settings at default. Make sure that the facial expressions is turned off, because that will be applied from the file that we have saved from the previous tutorial. And you can see that the characterization is automatically applied, so you don't have to do this process again. And now we can go to the facial profile editor. Click on Edit Expressions and load the file that we have saved from the previous tutorial. And now let's check if the expressions are applied on the character. It's working perfectly. And now, just like the previous tutorial, we'll go to the Bone Manager. And over here, we'll search for hip. We'll select all of these bones and click on Used over here. And let's go to the Scene tab, select the mesh of the tail over here, and let's rename this to Tail. And now comes the important part where we'll need to do the skin weights for each bone of the tail. I have actually tried various methods to do the skin weights in Character Creator, but I have found a method which makes it very easy to create the skin weights for a mesh like this. Let's go to the selection option over here. And based on the bone that we have selected, select the center vertices of that particular area. And then click on Grow multiple times to roughly select the portion that will be controlled by this particular bone. And we'll replace it with 1, which means that this whole area will be affected by this particular bone. And now we'll repeat this process to all the other bones of the tail. And once when this is done, we need to make sure that the skin weights is smooth. So let's go back to the paint option. We will select the smooth brush over here and change the strength to 100. And now we'll select each bone and smooth out all the areas of the tail. And we'll repeat this process for all the other bones as well. Select each bone and make sure all the faces of the tail is smoothened out. So you can have very clear and smooth movement of these faces when there is a spring joint movement. We are done with the skin weights and now we'll convert these bones into spring bones. We'll go to Edit Spring. We will change all the bones that we are going to use into active. And now we need to select the hardness point over here. Just make sure that by each child bone, we need to reduce the hardness by 1 point. So if this bone is at 5, we need to select the next bone and change that to 4, and so on. And now we'll select the main group over here and make changes to the mass, strength and bounciness. I have tried different values for the mass, but I found around 2 is the value which goes well with this kind of mesh. We can have the strength at the highest value, and I don't want any bounciness on the tail, so I'll just reduce the bounce value to 1. And now let's give a motion to this character and check the spring bones. So it's not working because every time we add a motion, the spring settings is turned off. So let's go back to edit springs. Select the group and let's turn this on. We can see some weird movements in the tail. This is because we have set the spring type to translate. So let's go back, select the bones and change the type to rotate. This looks good, but I want the tail to be a little more stiff. So let's change the hardness value. Let's increase it by 1. So make sure you increase for all the bones. I don't want to use this bone, so I want this area of the tail to be more stiff. So let's turn off the spring for this particular bone here. This looks way better. But now you can see there is some kind of deformation happening in the tail. So this is because we haven't done smoothing properly in that particular area. So let's go back to skin weight and then smooth out some of these areas on the tail. This looks much better. And that's how you can add a tail to a humanoid cat using the spring bones. And let's select the bones of the ears and click on used and bring back the spring settings from the previous tutorial. And let's save the project. And these are the final results of the tutorial. Thanks for watching.